Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon Blind in English. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're getting out of here very soon, don't worry about it. And then we're headed to the Temple of the Brotherhood, I believe it's called. But this one that we're at, Wellspring, is Magic Spring number 1. And off screen, I checked some stuff out. This affects stamina. And I'm not completely sure what effect stamina has in this. I mean, in Dungeons & Dragons, it affects how many hit points you have, and also against certain saves, or a save, saving throw. In this game, I don't know. But in any case, Citrine wouldn't have a benefit because her stamina is already maxed out at 50. We got Edgel at 43. Selena at 23. Nelvin at 23, and then Sabine at 35, and Valden at 45. So when I did it, not everyone increased, which is like, I guess, a random element. Yay. You inhale it and feel stronger than before, so it's not a strength one though. So obviously I'm not going to increase. Still at 50. Edgel is now 49 instead of... No, 47. Sorry, look at the wrong thing. 47, up from 43. Selena's maxed out now at 25. She was 23. Nelvin went up from 23 to 27. Sabine went from 35 to 37. And Valden went from 45 to 48, so hopefully that affects things in a positive way. Not sure if I'll ever be able to tell a difference. Anyway, we're off to the temple. So, on the birdie we go. Click. Trying to itch my elbow at the same time. Just scratch it, rather. Alright, so we're going straight south. And then this way over here somewhere is the Temple of the Brotherhood. Probably at the end of this road. Look at that. It's like craters. So we don't have to worry about taking this boat or not. We just have the eagle. And I can't get off here. Not surprisingly. Okay. So let us save. We're getting close to episode 150. That'll be... As you guys know, or probably know. An extra long episode. Interesting crystal-like. Wall or whatever. Oh, is that the beast that we heard about? It may very well be. Kind of looks like it's moving over, but it's not coming closer. We gotta put it to sleep with the sleeping potion. The wall before you is made of a single crystal. Citrine is unimpressed and lifts her weapon, hitting the crystal wall with all her strength. Then Citrine exclaims in astonishment, "Look at that! Not even the slightest scratch on the wall and my weapon is dented. If we want to get through here, we will have to think of something." You're really assuming that the player character is not female, even though they give you female portraits. Whatever. We will have to think of something. Well, how about we think of something of this? A little ahead of you in the passageway, there crouches an enormous demon, watching you coolly and calmly. Anything in these alcoves? There's something there. There's nothing there. In the recess to the west, you see a huge bowl containing rotten meat. Citrine comments, "That looks like the food bowl of a very, very large guard dog." Well, depends on how you define guard dog. Is this where we would put the potion? I mean, what if it's optional to poison this thing? What if we could fight it instead? No. Let's see what happens if we try to fight this thing. Let's give ourselves a fighting chance anyway, if at all possible. Barrier. Magical assault. And anti-magic wall. So if we want to fight it, guard demon. Advance. Kill eat. I don't know if we can. Let's move over, actually. I have a feeling if we could defeat this thing, it would take quite a while. Fireball. Cannot penetrate the magical aura. Guard demon made a critical hit. Edgel is dead just like that. Deflected the spell. Cannot penetrate the aura. Waterfall. Ice shower spell. Wow. Sabine deflected. Selena deflected. Ow, 120? Is that what it says? Deflected that spell. I'm gonna see if it's at all possible. She can't resurrect in combat, right? Yeah, wake up's not gonna work. Resurrection, wrong area. He's deflecting everything. I'm sure sleep's not gonna work. Thunderbolt? Row of monsters, yeah. It's also casting Thunderbolt. Deflected. Yeah, out of curiosity, really want to see this. Show monster LP. Medium healing. Oh, I forgot to stop. Keep moving over. not really paying attention because I don't think we have a chance here. Fireball again? It's, everything's being deflected. Mudslide, I guess. That's not that bad. Show monster LP. Fireball deflected. Oh! Unlimited. Or 1,000 out of 1,000, or whatever that is. Something into 4 digits, I'm guessing. Firestorm. Yeah, we can't hit it. Magical arrows. Wow. Firestorm. I don't think any of us is hurt. Got it by a single point at all. I'm not gonna bother healing and stuff. Critical hit on Valden. Imagine trying to fight this thing. And then leveling up, coming back, leveling up, coming back. How high a level do I have to be to destroy this thing? Not knowing that you have to... Critical hit on Citrine. The monsters advance? Oh, because we're on a... Well, the entire front row has been eliminated. Yeah, but you wouldn't know if you hadn't been paying attention to make the demon sleep potion, and then you'd keep running out. Well, this is an RPG. Critical hit. Bean's dead. And you would just keep leveling up. You're like, what do I have to be? Level 500 to beat this thing? It moved. It's attacking physically. Critical hit, Nelvin. 2 critical hits on Nelvin. Okay. I don't think he needed the second one. Earthquake. Well, the spell failed. Oh, I forgot to redirect. Not that it matters. 206 points. Okay. Thankfully, we don't have to do that. I'm guessing we're gonna put it in the thing's food. I figured we'd just throw it at it or, you know, feed it to it. But we do it this way, I'm thinking. So Edgel has it. Who has the other flint? Oh, he used up a flint and iron for the to make this. After you mix the demon sleep potion into the meat, it fortunately does not take long, and you see the demon creeping towards the bowl, apparently hungry. I forgot to add in that we're running away, because it would also eat us as well. In a few moments, he swallows the horrid-smelling meat, and suddenly his legs go weak, and he collapses. Just to be safe, you wait a moment, and you see the body of the demon start to dissolve into thin air. Shortly afterwards, there is nothing left of him. I thought this thing was supposed to put him to sleep. Instead, he's, like, been disintegrated. Okay. We disintegrated the thing. Alright, the passage is now unguarded. Oh, I want to check the walls, actually. Check for hidden doors. I mean, sacred doors. Illusory walls. Walls that are not real, that kind of thing. We're like stepping on the bowl, the rancid meat. Because there's nothing there. Just wanna be thorough here before we advance. So over here, I think when you see this on the map, it's like a telltale sign that there could be something over there. But doesn't seem to be that way. And I'm not even going to try this. I'm going to think we need to find a way to get past that. Actually. Let's try the harp over there. Valden holding it? Yeah. Nothing happened. The harp does not seem to have helped anything. But the item we seek to get through there might be through here. Oh. So we have three ways to go. I like east as a direction. Let's go east. Does this mean there's gonna be no other monsters here? Because that's the guard dog. Nope, there's gonna be more monsters. Oh, hello! Who the hell are you? Magical guards. Wow. Well, we don't have our protections on now because that was before I saved and then I restored that. So let's get magical barrier up. Attack that guard. You attack that guard. We'll throw a whirlwind in. That one, and you with that one. So I'm gonna save. In case weapons break. Which doesn't happen that often anymore. Boom. They're pretty cool looking. Reflected? How dare you? Agile, not attacking for that much. There you go. Magical guard. Ooh, 28 damage. Attacks twice. 33. Three attacks. Failed. They have three attacks each. Critical hit? Oh my... Oh. How often do they do critical hits? Is it rare? I could struggle through it. Maybe I'll try that. Medium healing. Agile. Wow. Whirlwind. So we can resurrect Citrine. It's just we have to either escape from or be victorious in the battle. I'm trying not to cheese it. I could just restore it. Three damage. Whoa. And we don't have my spells to like... Oh, we do. We have the defense. That's it. I managed to get that off before I died. I'm actually curious. Show the monster LP. Bottom spell failed. Oh my god, what? I am gonna restore. Now I'm gonna restore. I'm just curious how much HP these things have. I keep hitting the wrong thing. Yeah, Thunderbolt. Thunderbolt might be more effective. Because it's a line rather than everybody. Apparently it's working. I'll just survive long enough to see it. Oh my god. How do we survive this crap? We have 290 points each. Wow. I mean, I'm not completely sure. They do critical hits a lot. Which just one-shot us. He's hitting this one. Alright, let's do Thunderbolt. Actually, what about Sleep? Sleep would work on these? It would stop the critical hits from happening. Why not? Did it work? And I think they should sleep through attacks as well. I think that's what normally happens. Oh! Oh god! I think this one is asleep. And I'm sitting here with 9 hit points. Selena has the best speed. Use potion. How much does a healing potion 3 get back? Let her use it. Bottom. Healing potion 3 on Citrine, and Sabine will also heal. Medium healing. And I'm gonna try to get a magical assault on. And Thunderbolt. That's almost all the way up. How do you defect it when you're asleep? You should have put to sleep the other guy. She still has yet to heal, I think. Ouch. Well, I guess she did heal her. Yeah, try to put him to sleep. I think that's what we need to be doing. We'll get the anti-magic up, even though these things don't seem to be using magic. I'm gonna save as a separate. These battles are pretty challenging with the critical hits. Sleep spell. Did that work? It's awake. It's awake! It failed. Oh! It does say they're magical. Maybe with this on, their attacks will fail a lot. Still gonna try to put them to sleep. I mean, we have a lot of uses of that, so... It worked. At least for now. That's the trick. Have the anti-magic shield up. Right, that's what it's called. Anti-magic wall. And put him to sleep. No, not that one. Alright, so just a small healing. Just a train for now. One down. I'm doing damage again. I guess his spell failed. Put the big demon doggy to sleep, we'll put you to sleep too. It worked this time. I think sleep worked too. 40, oh. Go. 333 experience.